Hi! So today it's about the bioceramic sealers. In this video, I will give you an overview on bioceramic sealers and their obturation techniques. As we all know, these sealers have gained a lot of popularity these days, isn't it? Because they have certain unique properties. The first one is these are hydrophilic materials, which is biochemically a positive factor because they utilize the moisture which is present in the canal system and in the dentinal tubules, and they undergo hydration reaction. So the calcium silicate, it interacts with the water which is present in the canals and which is being supplied, and it undergoes hydration reaction, giving rise to the calcium silicate hydrate gel and calcium hydroxide. So this calcium hydroxide, in turn, it undergoes a precipitation reaction when it interacts with the calcium phosphate, and then it gives rise to the hydroxyapatite crystals. So this explains the osteoconductive potential and bone regeneration potential of this material. Consequently, the literature notes that many bioceramic sealers are bioactive, and throughout this setting reaction, the material maintains very high pH, that is at about 12. So this alkaline pH also explains its antimicrobial effect. And these materials, once they are, the setting reaction is over, these materials are dimensionally stable and they are insoluble and they don't shrink. Rather than shrinking, these materials expand, and the expansion is so minimal, which is just 0.2% of total volume of the material. So this slight expansion, it creates an impervious seal and it prevents the micro leakage. And these materials, they interact with the dentin and they form a mineralized intermediate zone with tag-like structures that extend into the dentinal tubules, and thus acts as a micromechanical anchor to the dentin. So the penetration of the root canal sealer into the dentinal tubules may also prevent the colonization of the residual bacteria via its antimicrobial effect. The working time of these materials is almost close to 30 minutes. So that is the reason these are quite user-friendly materials. And the setting time for various bioceramic sealers is reported to be between 2.5 hours to 5 hours. So basically the setting time, it depends on the amount of the moisture which is present. So it has been even reported that the setting time can be as long as even 10 hours also if the canals are completely dry. So this is very important here. Whenever we are using the bioceramic sealers, the canals should not be completely dry, but they should be partially moist. So here we are not supposed to dry the canals. And since these materials have faster setting time, so they show less washout phenomena and less toxicity and faster sealing also. And they are quite good as radio opaque materials, which is more than to the range of 8. And one drawback with these materials is that they cannot be removed. So this limitation is being overcome by using Gattapaccia core. So because we are using the Gattapaccia, it acts as a path or a channel to whenever we have to do a retreatment for the material to be removed, this acts as a path. So that is how having these good unique properties, now these are materials have become very popular. They are being used mostly when there is a periapical lesions and infections are there, whenever we expect a good osteoconductive property or regenerative capacity kind of things. That is the reason now various companies are manufacturing under the different names. So basically the pure bioceramic sealers are the ones which contain either calcium silicate or calcium phosphate or one of them as ingredients, the main ingredients. Apart from this, even the hybrid bioceramic sealers are available, which may contain maybe a resin as one of the components, or even MTA based sealers like Philipex. So these are various brands, which are some of the brands, few examples which are available in the market. So now coming to the obturation techniques, let us see the obturation techniques with the bioceramic sealers. So basically here these are called sealer based obturation, because whenever we are using the bioceramic sealers, here it is this, the obturation is more of the sealer and less of the guttapercha. Unlike the traditional obturations where we have more of the guttapercha and less of the sealer. Why we do this? Because the traditional obturations, we use the conventional sealers, like maybe for example zinc oxide, eugenol or non-eugenol based, or calcium hydroxide based. So these sealers resolve over a period of time, or maybe resin sealers. So most of the resin sealers, they shrink over a period of time. So when the sealer is either resolving or shrinkage is taking place, so over a period of time it is going to leave some voids, which can lead to the micro leakage. So that is the reason, to prevent or to minimize the micro leakage, the traditional obturations were said to have more of the guttapercha by minimizing the less sealer. So but unlike that, here we do more of sealer and less of guttapercha we leave in the bioceramic sealer obturations. These obturations are also known as the hydraulic condensations. So why hydraulic condensation? Because basically here the hydraulic sealer is the major part of the obturation, which is being condensed laterally and three-dimensionally with the help of a guttapercha cone. So this guttapercha cone is the one which is acting as a condenser and is also as a path for the retreatment. But remember, this hydraulic condensation technique is only for the bioceramic sealers, not for the other sealers, because as we discussed, they resolve or shrink over a period of time. And second thing is that traditional sealers, they don't bond to the dentin. So that is the reason whenever we are doing the traditional obturations, we need to opt for either a lateral condensation or a vertical condensation with minimal amount of the sealer. Whereas here we prefer a single cone obturation with more of the sealer, which is known as a hydraulic condensation. Here one more important thing is, whenever we are doing, previously in the past we were using the regular guttapercha points, but now we have the BC coated points are available. So these are the ones which are preferred, because these are being immersed and are coated with the nanoparticles of the bioceramics. So when we use these materials, they give rise to the better bonding and increased fracture resistance. So always preferred are the bioceramic coated guttapercha points. So let us see what is this hydraulic condensation technique. The standard hydraulic condensation technique which was given or which was explained was that first step is that once we have done the complete shaping and then the irrigation part is done, now we have done the master cone check, okay, with the radiograph and the clinical, we have done the master cone fit. And once we have done, thereafter what we do is we apply the sealer in the coronal and the middle third of the canal, and thereafter this sealer is being carried to the apical third and to the inaccessible areas through maybe a reamer or maybe a lenticular spiral in a counterclockwise direction, carry it to paint it on the all the walls of the canals. Then thereafter, with the gattapacha, we place the gattapacha to the working length, and we shear the gattapacha and we condense it. So this is what was the basic hydraulic condensation technique which was given for these materials. But then thereafter, apart from this, this is also said that for this hydraulic condensation technique, the magnification is must. When we work without the magnification, one may overfill the canals, or sometimes we may end up even with the voids also. And even sometimes, because see, here we have filled the canal with the hydraulic sealer, and thereafter we have placed just one gattapacha point. So this gattapacha may even suspend coronally. So after the obturation, we may realize that the obturation is looking short. So because these are the some problems with this technique, that is the reason some more variations of this standard technique have been introduced. So let's see what are all these techniques. So the hydraulic condensation, basically it is divided into two types. One is a cold or passive hydraulic condensation, or other one is the warm hydraulic condensation. So cold passive hydraulic condensation, again it's been divided into the basic technique and advanced technique. Basic technique is the one where we can do even without the magnification, whereas advanced technique, it has been said that better is to use the magnification. So this advanced technique is again of two types. One is the injection technique, other one is a hybrid technique. Just there is a slight variation or modification in the technique which has been named as the different techniques. So let us see individually about each technique. The first one is the basic technique. So as we have already discussed, we have done with the complete cleaning and shaping, and then we have done even the drying of the, the moisture part has been, the water part has been removed from the canal. We have done the confirmed cone fit. Then thereafter, the most important point is here on the GP point at the coronal reference, place either indentation or a mark or bend it, so that acts as a landmark when we are doing the obturation. So thereafter, we coat the gattapacha with a sealer. Properly, we have to coat all over on all the surfaces around 360 degrees. And thereafter, we carry this coated gattapacha to the canal and coat the canal walls also. And shear the gattapacha with either a ball burnisher or with a warm condenser, warm plugger. Just once we have to shear it, and with a cold condenser, condense the gattapacha. So the same technique, that is application of the sealer, can also be done with the master file. So here on the master file itself, we apply the sealer and then carry it to the canal and coat the canal walls. Even this technique also can be done. So what are the advantages of this basic technique? This is very useful either in the narrow canals or tortuous canals. So just simply we just coat and then place in the narrow canal. This is a very simple technique which is quite less technique sensitive, and most important is there is no wastage of the sealer. We know the bioceramic sealers are quite expensive. So rather than wasting the material, this technique can be done where we are using just the amount which is needed, and this can be done without any magnification. Now there is a small tip here. So how do we coat the gattapacha, or how do we coat the master file? So here we know these bioceramic sealer tubes, they are being supplied with a dispensing tip, right? So to dispense little material into this dispensing tip, thereafter separate this dispensing tip from the syringe, okay? So now the master apical file disinfect it by immersing it in the hypochlorite for 1 minute. Thereafter, clean it, and then from the rear end where you have dispensed the material, in that place insert this master apical file and coat the master apical file with the sealer, and then carry this to the canal, move it in the counterclockwise direction to coat the canal walls with the sealer, and thereafter one can obturate. Sometimes even whenever we feel if it is needed, even the gutta percha also can be coated in this way, similar way. So we place it in the rear end of the dispensing tip, coat the gutta percha and place it inside the canals. So here also first we disinfect the gutta percha because we have placed it inside the canal, right? So we disinfect it by placing it in the hypo and then we use it in this way. So this is one tip how to coat the either master file or gutta percha. And the other technique is, this technique usually I don't prefer, because once I have used a dispensing tip in this way, I don't prefer to use the same dispensing tip. So again, the same time, how much of the material I have dispensed, that I am wasting it here. So here I am sharing my way of doing this basic technique. So similarly, we have done here. First thing is we have done the master cone fit and we have done the indentation also. See, I have bent the GP at a coronal orifice, coronal level, at a coronal reference point. And I remove the excess moisture from the canal with a paper point. And then thereafter, like, you know, I leave the canals slightly moist, which is very important for this hydration reaction, not to dry them, otherwise which we do with the alcohol and then dry the canals, that we are not supposed to do, which is very important point here. And thereafter, now what I do is that I take little material, how much ever is needed, on the mixing pad, and I coat my gutta percha quite well on all the 360 degrees and carry it to the canal. Just I coat all the walls, and then I have placed both the cones in this. Now with the hot plugger, I just shear this gutta percha. If you don't have, you can just use even a ball burnisher and shear the gutta percha at the orifice level, and just condense it with the hand condenser, which is not hot one. Okay, it is just the hand condenser. I condense it. Now the excess sealer, to clean it with the ultrasonic tip, just run it on the walls of the chamber, not directly onto the GP or onto the sealer, and then just run it once and the entire sealer comes out, leaving the clean chamber. So this is the basic technique, which is very simple technique, where we are not wasting any material, and this can be done without any magnification. Now coming to the second technique. Now these two techniques, the coming two techniques, are supposed to be mentioned as the advanced techniques. They have just little variation. They are more or less the same. So among these advanced techniques, the first one is the injection technique. In this injection technique, what we do is we inject the sealer into the canal in the coronal and in the middle third, and then insert the GP and carry this sealer from the coronal and middle to the apical third of the canal. So here the magnification is preferred. Otherwise, as I mentioned, maybe sometimes, you know, we may do overfills, or sometimes the voids can be there. So better is to watch under the magnification while doing. So let us see here how I have performed this. Distal canal, I have done the empty obturation in this. Now in one of the mesial canals, what I am doing, see, the most important is that, you know, first I measure the length of the canal up to the middle third, and I have placed a rubber stop as a reference so that I don't go into the apical third. So I have filled the coronal and middle thirds, and the selected GP I have just inserted, took the material to the apical third, and the way I showed in the first video, I shared the GP and then I condensed it. Simple, right? So this is what is known as the injection technique. Now the third one is a hybrid technique. In this, the same way we inject the sealer in the coronal and in the middle third. In this, the only difference is, rather than just directly placing the GP inside the canal, we coat even the gutta percha also along with the sealer. So then, like in the first video, we coat the gutta percha with the sealer and then carry this coated gutta percha to the canal and then carry the material to the apical third, and then we just same thing, shear it, shear the GP and then condense it. So this is ideal for wider canals. When we have wider canals, when we feel there can be voids remaining, so better is to inject in the canal and to coat the GP also. So let us see the video here. So similarly, I measure my length up to the middle third and then I place a stopper in my applicator tip, and before that, yes, I leave the canal slightly moist. You can see the stopper there, and then I carried it to the middle third and I inject the material, the bioceramic sealer, inside the canal. Okay, now even I coat my gutta percha also point and then I carry it to the canal. So here I'm carrying my material to the apical third, and laterally also I'm spreading the material three-dimensionally, and then I shear and I condense with the cold condenser. Thereafter, with the ultrasonics, I just clean the pulp chamber area. So this is what is known as the hybrid technique. So this is, as I mentioned, preferred for the wider canal. So according to your canal system and according to the armamentarium which you are using, it is better to choose the technique. So this is the same case. Basically, it was a retreatment case where the patient reported with the intraoral abscess, and the patient was having it for a long term, almost for more than 10 years, and it is actually a re-acidic case. So we have done the master cone fit, where I had to do a lot of adjustment after the tuning and gauging, and that time the bioceramic coated GP was not available here. I was not having, so I used the regular GP, but if I do it today, then definitely I use the GP, the bioceramic coated GP here. So the mesial, both the canals, we have done the bioceramic, the hydraulic condensation we have done, and the last radiography showing the 1 year follow up, where healing is evident, not completed, because it is a long term, chronic long standing case. So definitely there is healing is seen, but still yet to take place a complete healing. So now coming to, that is what we are done with the cold hydraulic condensation, which is also known as a passive or synchronized hydraulic condensation. Now coming to the warm hydraulic condensation technique. So what we need to remember is, every bioceramic sealer is not compatible for warm condensation technique. Hence, following manufacturer's instruction is highly recommended, because traditional bioceramic sealers, they were introduced for cold hydraulic condensation technique, because heat might deteriorate the physiochemical properties of these hydrophilic sealers. Like for example, the BioRoot RCS, one of the first materials which is supplied as a powder and a liquid, separate powder and liquid. So in the, for this materials, the manufacturers, they recommend the cold hydraulic condensation technique. Okay, so there are various studies have been done on this material. Some of them are like the Josette Camerelli. She showed that when a warm vertical compaction technique has been done for this BioRoot RCS material, the application of the heat affected the setting time of BioRoot RCS. That is because evaporation of the warm water from the water-based sealer, but there were no chemical changes happened. Similarly, in Shinya Yamauchi's study, the BioRoot RCS, when the heat was applied up to 200 degrees Celsius for a different time, that is for 10 seconds and 30 seconds, the flow of the material has been decreased drastically. the flow has been decreased by 13 to 34% reduction. Even the viscosity of the material has been increased by 2 to 3 folds when the heat was applied to BioRoot RCS. Similarly, endosequence BC sealer. This is typically recommended with the single cone obturation technique because heat might deteriorate its physical properties by decreasing the bond strength. Even the setting time and the flow rate were also reduced when the heat was applied. That is the reason the Bressler introduced a new modified high flow material for warm vertical Gattapaccio obturation technique. According to the manufacturers, the high flow exhibited a lower viscosity compared to standard BC sealer when heated and is more radio opaque, making it optimal for warm vertical compaction technique. So Josset again in her study with endosequence BC sealer high flow, this is the recent modified sealer which was introduced for the warm vertical condensation. When in her study, she concluded that they exhibited the lower viscosity when heated and they neither showed any chemical changes when subjected to height. This is because they are supplied with non-aqueous vehicle preventing the desiccation. So even various other materials are recently have been introduced which are modified bioceramic sealers which are compatible with the warm vertical Gattapaccio technique. So it is quite controversial about the warm hydraulic condensation. Few studies are in favor of the warm hydraulic condensation, like the Heron et al. He showed that heat has not influenced, and some of them showed that the lateral canals have been filled better, and some of them showed that the apical third there was no impact. So these are the studies which were in favor. I'm just quoting few examples, and there are even few studies which are not in favor of the warm hydraulic condensation. So some of them said that, you know, there is no difference whether the cold or warm has been done. So it is before choosing, I mean, first one has to go through the literature and one has to read the manufacturer's instruction and then choose accordingly which one suits for that particular case and for that particular material. So now exactly what is this warm hydraulic condensation technique, how it is supposed to be done. So here I am mentioning a technique which is mentioned by the endosequence manufacturers. So how these are different is that they recommended to use the BC sealer high flow. This is the latest modified sealer with BC coated points, not the regular points. 150 series is the thing which the company recommends along with the BC pellets, and the temperature setting should be between 150 degrees Celsius to 220 degrees Celsius. And here, pre-fit the plugger only to 4 to 5 mm from the orifice of the canal, unlike the apical 4 to 5 mm for the warm vertical compaction with regulars. These are the main differences when we compare with the regular Gattapaccio with the conventional sealers and with the bioceramic sealers. In those cases, we go up to the apical third up to 4 to 5 mm from the working length, but here we restrict it to the coronal 4 to 5 millimeters. Okay, so and the secondly, we activate the plugger for shorter time here, only 2 to 3 seconds, and shear the GP and condenser rather than for the traditional where we do it up to 3 to 5 seconds. So these are the main differences for the warm hydraulic condensation. One is about the which sealer we are using. Preferred is a modified sealer, and which GP points preferred are GC coated GP points and the GC pellets, and temperature between 150 to 200, 250 degrees Celsius, and plug off it is in the coronal 4 to 5 millimeters, and the activate the plugger for less time, which is just 2 to 3 seconds, shear the GP and condensate. So this is what. And now the other technique, the Alfredo et al, they have demonstrated a new technique which is known as the hot modified technique of the obturation. So they conducted a study on Ryoko Guttaflow Bioseal. So this Ryoko Guttaflow Bioseal is not a pure bioceramic sealer, but it is, you can say, a hybrid one, which is composed partly of gutta patch of fluid and partly of the calcium silicate particles. But at the same time, they mentioned that this technique is not only for this material, it can be used for all the bioceramic sealers. They also showed by this hot modified technique, the heat doesn't reach the apical third, but it allows the better biosealer penetration inside the lateral anatomies. So let us see what is this hot modified technique of the obturation is, how it is different from the conventional obturation. So here again, the heat carrier temperature at 130 to 150 degrees Celsius instead of 200 to 250 degrees Celsius. So that means we keep it at a less temperature. And heat carrier insertion again, 8 to 10 mm short of the working length instead of 4 to 5 mm short of the working length. That means almost the same, from the orifice it goes up to 4 to 5 mm. Now thirdly, the penetration depth we are supposed to reach within 3 seconds rather than usual 5 seconds. So that means at 130 to 150 degrees Celsius, and we have already put a stopper at, you know, maybe coronal 4 to 5 mm, and within 3 seconds we just reach that point, and then we that means faster penetration of the heat carrier with slight increase in the pressure. So we reach faster, we shear the GP, and we condensate with slight increase in the pressure. This is to be done to ensure that the biosealer penetrates throughout the endodontic spaces. So in this hot modified technique, Alfredo et al, they concluded that with this new technique, the biosealer sets only around 2 minutes earlier than the normal technique. This happens owing to the reduced heat settings and fast penetration. That is the reason these modifications have been done. They also mentioned with this technique, the guttapacha itself doesn't have to enter the accessory canals, but to ensure the biosealer penetration throughout the endodontic spaces. So knowing all these things, now I am sure everyone understood that which technique to be considered when and which material to be considered when, and if at all we are doing the warm condensation technique, warm hydraulic condensation, what precautions to be taken, what measures to be taken. So I hope it is helpful to a certain extent, and thank you for kind here, patient here. Thank you very much.